This is a little tutorial on how to protect cells in a shared worksheet in Google Docs. So Google Docs is made for collaboration. You can invite other people to use a spreadsheet, but there's going to be times when you want them to be able to edit parts of the spreadsheet, but not the entire spreadsheet. So I made a quick example here just so I can illustrate how to protect certain cells or a range of cells. This is a mock spreadsheet. So say I'm the HR department and I have a list of names and a list of issues with these people. And then I'm gonna have someone else respond, log in and respond. I really don't want the person who's logging in to be able to change column B, really column A either for that matter, but we'll just act like it's column B for now. So you want to protect these cells and just these cells. So you select them, you right click, and you choose name and protect range. Now I'm just going to name it don't look. And this is a range that I had already selected. I'm going to check protect. And I'm going to say done. And then it comes up and asks me, well, who do you want to protect it from? This is me right now on this browser I'm working with, so I obviously don't want to protect it from myself. But this other person, which I'm going to flip over to, is the person from whom I'm going to protect it. So I'm going to say this person can view, but can't edit. Then I'll click OK. That's a little off the screen, but I think that's what it says. Hold on 1 minute. Save changes. So this should be protected. If you're looking here, I just did this before as well, so it's actually protected twice, but just look at this one. So here's my other browser that's logged in as a different person. And if you look, you can see the diagonal lines on here, which is an indication that these are protected. So I'm gonna try to change this. Say I'm Kelly and I'm looking at this and I'm supposed to respond. Well, you know, Kelly's going to want to go in here and type none. So as soon as I try that, it says you can't do it. So that's a quick little tutorial on why you want to do it and how you want to do it, which is protect cells or a range of cells in Google Docs.